My name is Jamil.
And here are your weekly announcements.
On Tuesday, November 22nd, there is an 11:30 dismissal.
From November 23rd through November 25th, Brookwood School District will be on Thanksgiving break.
On Monday, November 28th, there is a boys basketball game at home and a girls away game against Columbia. There is also a chess tournament.
On Tuesday, November 29th, there is a boys basketball game at home against James Hart. There is a girls basketball game away at Washington and a chess tournament.
On Wednesday, November 30th, there is a boys basketball game at home against Cremonie.
Good luck, Brookwood.
At 1621, the Plymouth Colonists and Wampanoag Indians shared an autumn harvest feast that is acknowledged today as one of the first Thanksgiving celebrations in the colonies. For more than two centuries, days of Thanksgiving were celebrated by individual colonies and states.
It was until 1863, in the midst of the Civil War, that President Abraham Lincoln proclaimed a National Thanksgiving Day to be held each November.
Thanksgiving Day is traditionally a day for families and friends to get together for a special meal.
The meal often includes a turkey, stuffing, potatoes, cranberry sauce, gravy, pumpkin pie, and vegetables. Thanksgiving Day is a time for many people to give thanks for what they have.
On the first Thanksgiving, there was no pumpkin pie. Although it is now a staple in most Thanksgiving dinners, Illinois is the top producer of pumpkins.
Thanksgiving Day in the United States is traditionally a holiday to give thanks for the food collected at the end of the harvest season.
So remember what you are thankful for and
have a great Thanksgiving.
This week is Thanksgiving.
Here are what people are thankful for at Brookwood on this holiday.
Celine, what are you thankful for this holiday?
I'm thankful for still being alive.
Ms. Cruz, what are you thankful for?
I am thankful that our school collects the pennies for patients. The money is donated to the American Cancer Society. I have a 9-year-old niece, my godchild, who has leukemia, and I'm thankful that our school helps out, that they can help children with leukemia, and then the money goes for research. And I'm thankful that my niece's Anna Rose is doing very well right now.
Josie, what are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for having my family around.
Ms. Maglio, what are you thankful for?
I am thankful for the phone call I received early this morning from my son, who's in basic training and is doing very well, and just passed his final exam for his physical training.
I'm thankful this year, Bria.
I'm thankful for being able to spend quality time with my family.
What are you thankful for this year, Ms. Mitchell?
I'm thankful for family and friends and to be in good health. Everybody doesn't have those things. So thankful for those things.
Josh, what are you thankful for this year?
I'm thankful for my family. So, Anika, what are you thankful for this year?
I'm thankful for my great-grandma still being alive and my family.
Here are the Brookwood birthdays for November 20th through December 2nd.
Cleona H., November 27th.
And Gina L., November 30th.
And Abraham C., November 30th.
Happy birthday to you all.
Hi, I'm Chanel with your Thanksgiving week forecast. Today it'll be mostly sunny but windy with highs in 49 degrees. Expect showers on Saturday with a high of 53 degrees. Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday, it'll be mostly cloudy with a high in the mid-40s. But don't worry, on Wednesday, it'll be partly cloudy with a high of 45 degrees. And on Thanksgiving Day, it will be partly cloudy with highs also in the mid-40s. Sorry. Next weekend, take out your umbrellas because we'll have showers with temperatures also in the mid-40s. I guess this week is just all mid-40s. Sorry, people.
Please wash your hands after using the bathroom. Please place all trash in the garbage and all toilet paper in the toilet.
Please only use the bathroom during the passing period.
Only ask to use the washroom when the necessary first. If you discover a problem in the bathroom, please identify and adopt immediately.
Please use the bathroom quickly and return to class properly.
Hi, I'm Ms. Pam Bartoshevitz with the Brookwood Junior High Learning Center, and I'm also the Learning Center Director for Brookwood Middle School. And today we're very fortunate to have Ms. Rhonda from the Glenwood Linwood Public Library from the Reference Department come and talk to us about a brand new reading challenge they have for us. And we also have
the shark!
Now, we have some questions for Ms. Rhonda. Janetta, will you please start?
So, Ms. Rhonda, how did you come up with the idea for the reading rivalry competition?
At the library, we're always looking for new ways to encourage kids to read. And one of our staff members is Jackie, who works on the bookmobile that comes around to the different areas in the community. thought it would be a healthy competition to challenge kids of all ages to compete for who would read the most in both Glenwood and Linwood. So it was Jackie's idea, and we decided to ask around and see if that would be a good idea for us to have that competition to encourage kids to read outside of the regular schoolwork.
What do you want to accomplish with this competition?
Just what I said, to encourage kids to read outside of the work that they have to read in school. We see a lot of kids come in the library every day, and during the summer we have our summer reading program. But we know that the same kids that are interested in reading during the summer may want to read also during the school year and their break time also to come into the library and check out books. So to encourage them to do that, we thought it would be a healthy competition to pit both the Glenwood students and the Linwood students against each other to see who it is, who would read the most in the communities.
Who can participate?
Children of all ages. For the younger kids who aren't reading yet, their parents would record the number of minutes that their parents are reading to them. For the older kids who are reading independently, they would record the number of minutes that they are reading outside of their schoolwork. So kids of all ages.
What can we read for?
We want to encourage reading of books, magazines, graphic novels count, books on CD, but no texts and no information that you're reading on the computer, and no schoolwork that you're reading in their textbooks. If you have accelerated reading books that you're reading for school, those do count. So we want to encourage book reading. So we are primarily focused on that in that sense.
So what prizes will we give for the competition?
We want to encourage participation in the program by giving some good prizes. I know a lot of kids listen to a lot of music, so we wanted to give an iPod is one of the gifts, or one of the prizes, possibly a Wii or a PlayStation or a PSP. Something that would really stoke the interest or increase the interest of the participants.
How many kids are participating?
Well, I looked at them before I came over, and we have well over 100 kids signed up, but I have to tell you, Glenwood kids have a lot of work to do. Most of our participants right now are from Glenwood. So we really need Glenwood residents, or the kids in Glenwood, to come in and sign up. You don't have to come in. If you can't make it into the library, you can call us and give us your contact information. And if you don't have a log sheet, you can start one at home. You can just record that information on a piece of paper, and once it's filled in, you can bring it to the library, and we'll record it on our own spreadsheet, the number of minutes that you're reading it each day.
Miss Rhonda, would I be able to collect the students' names and then get them the logs? And
yes, you can.
Okay.
You can do that, as long as you give us their contact information, because we need that in order to invite them to the end of the program party and contact them if they're the winner. But they can, at any time they're in the library, come in and drop off their log sheets, the ones that they create themselves or the ones that we officially give out at the library. You can come in at any time and give us that information, and we'll record it.
So how many people can be the top two?
Right now we're talking about a top two, but if we have so many people participate, I'm sure we'll talk more about adding some more prizes to the mix. We have to talk to the director about that.
Oh, one more question, please, Ms. Rhonda.
Sure.
We have students here at our Brookwood schools that also attend, live in Lansing and Chicago Heights. Can those children still be in the reading club?
No, unfortunately not.
Okay.
It is not where you go to school, it's where you live.
Where you live.
It's where
okay.
you live. And it's Glenwood residents versus Linwood residents.
Okay. Ladies, anybody else have any more questions? Janetta.
Like, Okay. What do you like about the what's your favorite author?
I read a lot, and I have all my life. And in fact, I'm excited about this program because anytime I can encourage, we can encourage people to read on their own and for enjoyment is a great plus. I like to read a lot of thrillers and mysteries. I read a lot of James Patterson books. I read Stephen King, actually my favorite all-time book when I was probably in middle school was The Stand by Stephen King. It's one of my favorite books.
And James Patterson writes for young people now as well.
He certainly does. He's a teen author now, so he writes both adult and teen novels.
Excellent. Anyone else? Well, Ms. Rhonda, thank you so much for coming. Appreciate it.
Well, thank you for inviting us.
Thank you. Thanks for joining us.
Next up, we have the Brookwood Cheerleaders cheering on the basketball players.
1, 2, 3, 4, Indian fans, let's hear. Stand up and show your spirit.
The west side, so I reach for my 40 and I turn it up. Designated driver, take